And hello YouTube. Well, it's been a while since we've done a video. I just thought I'd do a quick live video letting you know about the new Type I TP scope that I've got. Let's just show you what we've got set up here. So basically we've got the TP software installed. This is the case it came in. Got it hooked up onto my big screen as well. That's the scope itself in the case. Hardwired USB high speed cable. Couplers there, so you can couple the scopes together. You can actually put as many scopes as you want together. I've got three channels connected. We've got, can't see any comments. Basically what we've got here, we're using the sacrificial Hyundai again, and I'm just back probing various things. I've got the throttle position sensor back probed down there where the yellow probe is, the map sensor, and the O2 sensor. Hi Haroon, how are you mate? Are you alright? And what I've got basically, I've got the map sensor and the throttle position sensor reference to battery negative. And I've got the O2 sensor connected differentially. I'll just show you show you what we've got here. Let's get that big screen out of the way. Just hang on. Right, so what we've got, a thing here called safe ground. The green circles there. That isolates the ground, so you don't get any short circuits within the ground, no matter how you connect it. And then channel 3, which I've got on the O2 sensor, I've got that connected differentially, so it's actually measuring the difference between the ground on the sensor and the actual sensor signal. So all I've been doing there, I've been doing a fast sweep test, a fast idle test on the O2 sensor. Yellow's throttle position, red is map, and green is O2 sensor. And what you can actually see, if you look at the difference in the clarity on the signals, let's just pull the green one down out of the way so you can see it. If you look at the clarity on the O2 sensor signal, which is connected differentially, and then the other two sensors which are connected reference to battery ground, there's a considerable difference. So I think for most of the stuff I'll be doing stuff connected differentially. The big downfall for the 4425 for me was the noise. The noise really upset me. Yeah, Mark, I can change the background. Is it a bit shiny, is it mate? It's dead easy to change the background. All we do, we go into colours here. We can have night, we can have blue, we can have green, red, like a foggy white, and then we can have an Arctic white screen as well. So we can change the screen. We can also change the channel colours. So let's say, for example, if I wanted channel 1 to be a different colour, I can go into there and I can pick whatever, you know, I can pick whatever colour I want. It's like now, channel 1's turned into a black, you know, literally I can do whatever I want with it. So that might help with, filming with glare and stuff like that. I'd be very, very honest. after using Pico for so many years, it's a struggle, you know, getting used to a new scope. But it seems to be a lot more powerful, and the clean lines of when it's connected differentially, that's a big bonus for me. I use noise. You know, there's a lot of diagnostic value in noise. So without filtering stuff, I'll be able to see the noise on the, you know, on the signals and stuff like that. It's not been easy. I mean, I've been at this most of the day today and I'm still just grasping the basics. Spent an hour trying to set up, you know, custom probes and stuff like that, compression testing and all that. But we're getting there slowly. The actual quality of the unit, it's really, really well made. The build quality is fantastic. Mark, the 4425, it was picking up 50 hertz, mate, even in the middle of a car park. Now, I'm not going to lie, I'm not going to say I'm not missing my Pico, but this is definitely a challenger for it. This can also operate in two different methods. You can either have it streaming real time live like the Pico, or you can poor Ryan Dye. He's a poorly car again. It is. Yeah, so you can either have the scope in streaming mode, which is real time, or you can have it in block mode, whereas the screen only updates when it's filled the screen up. So you can do one or two ways. There's all sorts of stuff in it, inputs, outputs, data collectors, all sorts of stuff. I'll show you these, just the overall quality. The leads are really, really nice. You know, it comes with a million different types of alligator crocodile clip. And the one thing, I'll just show you this. This is the end of the test lead, the ground side, obviously. But what it's got the push down. So you can actually put that straight into my Pico breakout box or any other 4mm connector without having to cut the sheaths off, which is what you have to do with a Pico or use an adapter. The lead qualities. Really, really nice. Everything's finished off with epoxy lined heat shrink. The probes themselves, let me show you these probe kits that you get. So in the probe kit that you get with it, we've got the bendy probes, really good quality. We've got also differential attenuators, and it comes with a warning card with these attenuators. The differential, and the thing is, the outsides of them are actually live. They're actually carrying the voltage. It's not, you know, it's not referenced to battery ground or anything like that. So whatever's on one end of the probe is actually on that metal collar there. So you've got to be careful with those. But the good thing is, if we've got, let's say for example, we've got my laptop there now running. So I've got my laptop connected up. That's the Sentinel key. You get a dongle with the ATIS software, with the brand specific software. I've got my oscilloscope connected here, a mouse, I've got it connected to a screen, I've got it wired up to the mains. But you look at that signal, it's clear, there's no 50 hertz noise on that O2 sensor signal whatsoever. And that's because using it differentially with the safe grounds and all that sort of stuff, it's not picking up any noise from the power pack for the laptop. It's not picking up any 50 hertz from the light. I mean, you know, I've got a twin tube light here running. Oh, the case is also crash proof. So there we go. You know, it's not picking up any 50 hertz, anything like that. I'm really, really pleased with it. It's going to be a struggle using Pico for over 10 years. The software's not, I'm not finding it as intuitive as the Pico stuff, but I'm finding the scope itself very, Tommy, no, everybody chat, TFA Solutions there, he's the guy who kindly supplied me scope at less than cost price and threw me some extras in. So if you're in the UK or Europe, it's definitely the premier option for going and having a look at the TP Type I, however you call it, scope. I'm very, very happy with it. So it'll take me a while to get used to it, but it is what it is. So what we'll do, we'll just fire the car up now and we'll set the scope running so we can show you.
How's that now?
That's all right, yeah. So literally set the scope running. So let's get rid of that there, big screen. Set the scope running. Let's go and start the car up. I like pie as well, Keith. So you see, nothing's happening there now. And there the screen's just updated, and then it'll wait till it goes along now. Maximum input voltage of the channels, I think it's set to, I think it's 80 volts, but obviously with the attenuators then, 20 to 1 attenuators, so you should be alright. So you see there in block mode, literally it's updating as the screen fills up. Oh, there you go, Tommy says 200 volts. Then if we just go on to give it a little bit of a fast idle. Let's give it a fast idle for a few seconds. The old iron die sounding a bit ropey now. I've had injectors disconnected, coils scoped, everything. Yeah, there might be a few fault codes in this. So fast idle for a bit, get it moving. Off the throttle. And a nice little wide open throttle there. Clear the dust out of it. We stop the scope. So there we go. So we stop the scope there now. Like I say, if you look at that there, the O2 sensor's connected differentially. There's not a bit of 50 hertz in that. Not a bit. And then if I want to zoom in, I can either zoom it horizontally, vertically, or I can just grab it. So literally, just drag it like that. Zoom into there. Yeah, it does, Keith. It looks all right, mate. So we'll get some vertical cursors in. Drag one across there. To when the O2 sensor started reacting. Left-hand side onto when I first put the throttle. Yeah, it's definitely fast enough for Canon FlexRay. I mean, this is the one gig, this will capture up to 1 gig of samples, and then hit the measurement screen, and then it gives me the measurements there. So my response time for my O2 sensor, 351 milliseconds, gives me my voltages. So we'll bring these cursors in as well. So that'll measure me wide open throttle and my bottom one idle. So it does, you know, it does everything for you. So that's that. And I'm using the free running software, the multi-channel software. I'm not even using the ATIS there. So literally now, if I just close that down. I mean, I can save this if I want. Literally save it as whatever I want. You can see there I've got a few known goods now. It could well be, Keith, you're right, yeah. Yeah. So we'll close that down. Look at that, I've even been reading the manual. First time in my life for years and years and years, I've actually read the book. That's been a struggle. So we'll minimize that. And then what we can do here, we go here, you see we've got multi-channel software, or we've got the ATIS software. So we click on ATIS. It starts up, and this will only work if you've got the Sentinel key and the dongle in. But you can install it on as many computers as you want, but obviously you only get one dongle. So this ATIS software is by GMTO. We can go into brand specific. There are all the brands that it currently covers. Obviously, there's a limited coverage on some, good coverage on others. So I don't know. Let's have a look. Let's see what we've got for BMW. Into BMW. Let's say what. E91. Start search. And these are all the BMWs it does. Let's look for something. Well, let's take what, an E91 there, 2 litre diesel, 318D, running the EDC 16C35. Gives me wiring diagrams. Everything in blue is hyperlinked, everything in green is generic. Although that shouldn't be, that's definitely not English, that. Turbo druck sensor. Wonder what a turbo druck sensor is. I might have to have a look at the language. So yeah, we've got engine management wiring diagrams. Let's have a look at the knockiness paucity sensor hall. There we go. So three wire, that's either, what's that going to be, cam or crank, or would it? Oh, there we go. The purpose is measuring to determine the relationship between the cam and the crank after TDC recognition. All right, so it gives us measurement conditions, diagnostic information, and then if we click on that button there, it opens the scope up into a preset, and it also gives us a known good cam crank. Yeah, so there we go, we've got a known good cam crank for this engine, all built into the software. You can have it on or you can have it off. And the scope's already set up. So all literally I've got to do now is connect up to the two sensors, and we've got a known good and that all built in. So all in all, it's pretty good stuff. So yeah, I'm dead lucky, to be honest, because diagnosed Dan first put me onto the TP type I scope, and then Brendan Ryan from Ryan's Automotive.ie, they kindly sent me one on loan. I had that on demo for a month, and now Tommy from TFA Solutions, he's sold me, you know, I've got one for him. So yeah, so if you're in Ireland, Ryan's Automotive.ie. And if you're in the UK or Europe, TFA Solutions. I will, when the video's uploaded and edited, I'll put links to both companies in the video. And yeah, jump over onto the Facebook group. We can start a discussion going. Once I've actually got to grips with the software and that, I'd see no reason why I can't start doing training courses on this scope if anybody's interested. But I doubt it'll be for a few months yet. I've really, really got to get up to speed with it. So, yeah. So we've got Ricky Sweeting coming over from Marbella in the morning. He's doing a two-day ride along with me. So hopefully we'll have a few live videos over the next couple of days. And we've got the training course at Andrew Parsons' place on Sunday in South Wales. What else have we got coming up? Oh, the DPF doctor training session in Ulverston the week after. So yeah, we're busy. And then we've got, he's flying over, Keith. He's actually here now, so we'll be meeting up with him in the morning. And then what have we got then? I think November we've got loads of stuff going on. But when it's uploaded and that, and I'll edit the description and everything later, put some links in, some cards in and stuff like that. Yeah, there'll be a bit of information here, so gonna get off now. It's well past knocking off time. I'm tired, I've been scoping all day long, my head's battered, I've been reading manuals, that's how frazzled my head is. And yeah, but overall, all in all, the Type 8 seems like it's a really, really good rival for the Pico. Have you got Ivan with you, have you? I thought he was doing lift engineers or something now, wasn't he? He's a factory engineer or something. Glad to see he started putting a few more videos out, that's for sure. Yeah, we watched Paul last night struggling with manifold bolts on his RV. That was entertaining for a couple of hours, that was. Right, so anyway, to round it off, it's been a long day, my head's battered. I've not been using a Pico, I've been using a new Type I scope. And hey Big, thanks for watching, and we'll catch you again soon. Look out for the live videos over the next couple of days. Bye for now. And I can't see my phone off again. Catch you later. See you later, Keith. And my phone won't turn off. That's it. End.